Alright guys, today we're going to do a mid-taper. We're going to start it out here with my Babyliss FX Rosegold trimmers. We're going to go right about almost the top of the ear. And then we're going to take our guideline about a half an inch up. So that was an open guard. And then I'm going to close it up right here. And just open it just a tad, just a little bit, just to bust out that first line. Open it up a little more. And the key to these tapers is you want to stay really low when you're taking out your guidelines. You want to keep the guidelines not too spaced far apart. You want to keep them closer together. So this is my one open. So it's my one open guard. One guard open. We're going to go up another half inch or so. And we're going to close it up halfway. And then close it up all the way. And we're just knocking out any heaviness. Depending on the hair texture, depending on the coarseness of the hair, you're going to have either an easy or harder time blending out the lines. So I'm going to use my zero guard to get out that second line right there that I made with my one guard. So that line is in between the half, the open, and the one guard. And I'm going to use my one and a half guard, clean up the top, the bulk of the area on top of the, where I just faded. And you can see behind his ear there, there's a little bit of a heaviness. You want to take that out, but you don't want to take out, you don't want to take it down too much, because then you're going to lose that heaviness all the way behind his ear. And you want to keep a bit of that shadow, because it's a taper, it's not a full fade, right? So you don't want to take out that heaviness. So I used my number two guard before this guard, and then I used my one and a half again, just to cut into that little area right above the ear. And then this is my one guard open. And I'm just going with the growth of the hair. I don't want to cut anywhere other than that spot right there that I just pointed at. And this is the zero guard. And we're going to use that to just make it nice and flush. So it's a nice taper. We still got all the spots that need to be heavy are heavy. And now I'm just fading his beard in a little bit. I'm going to use a number two. Open that up. And clean that up. And you don't want to go too low with this, because you don't want to take off his beard. This technique will vary depending on the beard itself. It really depends on what you're looking at when the client first sits in your chair. So I'm going to use a one and a half guard after the two. And we're going to go pretty much right where the earlobe, just below the earlobe. That's where my one's going to be, and that's where my half guard's going to be. So this is open right now. This is a one and a half guard open. And then we're going to take the one guard, open it up, and right where the earlobe is, we're going to hit it from there. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like and comment on my channel. I would appreciate it, you guys. So that's a one open, and then we're slowly gonna close it up. Just close the lever as we go up. We don't wanna close the lever and go down, because that would just make a new line. So what we're gonna do here, we're gonna use my zero guard. With the zero guard all the way open, we're gonna stay above the area where I hit it with the one, and we're gonna close it gradually, close the lever 1/4 each time, and then we're gonna open up our guard with our clipper with no guard, sorry, and we're just gonna chop at it. So I'm using it open, and now it's halfway closed, and now it's almost all the way closed, and you can see each time I hit it, I stay above my initial guideline. So here we're just hitting it with the one and a half again, just just making sure we get rid of any heavy spots in that lower area. And you can see it's coming out really nice. You can do one, the one open. We're just getting out any dark spots that you may see. And you can see it's working really nicely. And you can see I'm using the corners of my blade a lot as well. And now we're gonna start up on the other side. And I'm gonna kinda zoom past this a little bit. We'll go quickly. It's the half guard. Close it up a little, open it just a little bit, open it more, open it a little more, and that line is gone. So use the one guard after that. You don't wanna go too high with the one. You might ruin the shape of the taper. And then I'm using my 1.5 just to get rid of the bulk. Now we're gonna use the half guard open and get rid of even more of the bulk. And you can see in the back again, he has a little bit of heaviness right behind the ear. You don't wanna go too far back behind the ear because then you're gonna ruin the shape of the taper and the overall haircut. And now I'm using my number 2 just to soften that heaviness above my guidelines up. His hair growth on this side of the head's a little different, so I do have to move my hands in a different way, different angles. And now we're gonna do the beard again. We started with the 2, then the 1.5, then the 1, and then we'll go to the 0 guard. Open that up, close it up. Each time you're closing it, you're going higher than before. And now we're gonna get started on the back, the neck taper. So sometimes I like to make a rainbow shape with my tapers, but for this particular case, I did not do that. I just left it more straight across. This is my cousin, by the way, my cousin Nav. They were here for about a week. They were visiting from Vancouver, and I decided to do a nice little tutorial on him. I thought he had pretty nice texture hair. This is only my second time cutting his hair, by the way, too, so I really busted it out for this tutorial. So you can see, I made the initial guideline, used a 0 to get the initial bald line out, or the 0 line out, and then I opened it about a quarter, and I'm just going above that first section that I made. Opening it up a little more. And you can see I'm using the corners a lot. You want to be really careful with tapers. You want to stay right underneath your original guideline. It's really easy to mess up a taper. But once you understand a taper, it's a pretty quick haircut. It's all about the motion and the flick of your wrist. It's all about not going too high, flicking when you're supposed to. You can see I'm using the back of the blade to get out any harder lines with that Babyliss trimmer that I used in the beginning. And I'm using my corners a lot, and a lot of lever play. See, I close it up a little more. If there's a dark spot higher up, you're gonna wanna open your guard up. If it's lower down, you wanna close your guard. So now I'm using a 1 open. One guard all the way open. Going again about a quarter inch to a half inch up. Not too high, because I do want to keep it a pretty low taper. And then I'm closing my guard all the way, getting out that initial line. You want to make sure you're brushing, combing your hair down, brushing your hair down, because every time you hit it with the guard, it is gonna move up a little bit. It's gonna move out of the way. It's not gonna show you exactly what you're gonna see. And this is the 1.5 guard open. And we're just getting rid of more of the bulk right above that, the taper. And I'm just cleaning up that bulk, And I'm using a taper blade right now. So I took the blade off of my Wahl 1919 clippers, the 100 year anniversary clippers, and I put them onto my Magic Clips, and that blade is a taper blade as opposed to a fade blade, so it has more of a scooping effect when you're doing your fades. And that really helps me with not creating any new lines. I do sometimes go back in with my fade blade just to touch it up for detail work, but you just gotta be careful with that. Just for the tutorial purposes, I'm gonna use just this one clipper. We'll get more into the detailed fading later on in the channel. You can see that taper's coming out really nice. I'm just using the half guard, the zero guard, to clean up any little lines that might be left behind on the bottom. And you can see those lines are just getting diminished each time I go over it. And patience is key with any sort of haircut, especially fades. Sometimes you'll pass it over once or twice. That's not enough. You gotta hit it a bunch of times repeatedly to get those lines out, to get that heaviness out. And you can see there's little spots that I'm not happy with. I'm going back with my 1.5 guard to clean up those areas that I might have not passed over enough. Left some heavy spots. You can see a dark spot right there that I'm gonna hit with my 1.5 guard, or my one guard, sorry, that's open all the way. And you can see they're going away quite nicely, but still maintaining the overall taper. So I'm gonna hit it with some Osis hairspray, high hold hairspray, blow dry it using my Dyson blow dryer. And we're gonna hit it with the Andis Slimline Pro Trimmers. These are very zero gapped. And I like to follow right where the hairline goes over the ears. So right where I know that's gonna arch around over the ears, that's where I make my line on the back. And you can see it follows right up to that ear line. A nice way for beginners is to start at the ear line. Start right there where I'm doing it right now, where I'm cutting. And start there and then follow your line all the way down to the neck. Because sometimes if you start at the neck, you are going to go too much into his nape. And it's just going to look off. When it grows back, it's going to look like not the greatest. He's going to have, it's going to look like a pushed back taper on the neck. So here's a little trick I like to use sometimes. I put a little bit of talc powder. This isn't talc powder, this is actually all natural. It's oatmeal, organic green tea, and lavender, but it works just the same as talc powder. So you could use talc powder. I myself stopped using talc powder a little while ago just for various reasons. And you can see it gives it a nice, nice finish. It dries everything up. And this works really well if you want to take a nice video, or if you want to take a nice photo of your cut and you want to highlight the heavy areas of the haircut. This is a nice way to do it. Instead of using like a blade, if you use a blade, sometimes it's going to cause irritation. My cousin here, he doesn't use a blade on his skin. Cause a lot of irritation, so this is the way I'm going to do it. And there you guys have it. This is the full taper tutorial. It was pretty quick. I hope you guys liked it. I hope you guys try out a taper. Remember to subscribe to my channel, like and comment, you guys. I'll be back with another video next week.